Alright guys, it's me Morpheus, it's Carlos. This is insane. This must be the longest YouTube video to ever be on YouTube. I may have to edit this twice just to compress it, I don't know. I have a 4 gig card here, I have a 2 gig card here, I just popped in my spare SD card in there. These are full to the brim with information, with video. This one here that I'm shooting now, I actually dropped the quality one more. It's like 320 by 4, by 240, I don't know, whatever the YouTube standard is. That's how I'm uploading this one here. I'll edit these together. Right now, this one here, the one you're watching right now, this will be at the beginning of the video. This is a long video, guys. So if you must, click off, shut it down, come back to it later. You know what I mean? Just remember where you're at. All right, I'm at 20 minutes, 38 seconds. You know, kill it, shut it down, close the window, go do what you gotta do, have fun. Come back, when you pop open this video again, just go to the 20 minute, you know, click on it, you're at 15 minutes. Alright, 5 more, okay. And start watching again, because this is a long video, and again, this is the only way I thought that I could do this, just blast through my email the best I can, and, you know, so there you go. Just go ahead and do it that way, alright? I don't expect you to sit here for a whole hour with me and listen to my emails that I'm reading, so... Cool, let me close this out, and again, this here will be spliced in the beginning, alright? Peace. Alright guys, it's me Morpheus, it's Carlos, and it's 10 o'clock, Sunday, October 12th. I just figured I'd, before I totally run through all these emails, you know, totally delete them, I'll at least try to answer some, you know, on video. I'm not going to do this all the time, but... maybe if I do get a little backed up, I'll try to go ahead and bang them all out, you know, on a video or something. So, let me go over here to my comments. Cool, I was hitting some up earlier, and there's only 145 now, right? So, here we go. I normally start at the very back, you know, I just go next, 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 so I hit the last page. I'm going to hit all the early ones first now. You know, because I know some of them have to do with, you know, haters. Come on, really? My channel? Hey, man, which skin? You know what I mean? So I know some of these are probably related to the thing that MacBook Trainer, you know, that video he threw up. Like I said, it's 10 o'clock now. Here's Tressa. It's 10 o'clock now, so I know some of these have to do with that. Let me go ahead and I got a ton of invites, friend invites, yes. We'll approve them. Personal messages. Alright, here we go. So, first one, haters. Oh, geez, this is a long one. Hey, Carlos, you seem pretty wound up at the moment after the idiotic email. And I just wanted to say some, don't stress, man. That guy was just an, and I can't say it. Who is jealous that you get free cases and he doesn't? It's just an envy, mate. You're entitled to keep every case you receive. Yeah, I know. I think it's great that you want to give them away and not make a profit on them. Yeah, right? I mean, that's what I thought. Maybe I should end this whole giveaway thing and just, you know, put them all on eBay or something. Which would totally be cool. I mean, you know what I mean? I hope you receive the that I sent you. Yeah, okay. That was a PayPal thing, by the way. See what I mean? I knew a lot of these things were going to be PayPal related right from the top. I haven't read any of these. I still try to go to the bottom and work my way up. This is a long message. Also want to know how you're getting along with the Griffin. Clarify. Yeah, that case is pretty badass. It works. I've been taking pictures all day just for the hell of it, just to see how well it works. But that really nice finish, that shiny finish on the back end of that, it's totally scratched up. It's like a lot of hairline scratch, a lot of scuffs, and I take care of it. You know what I mean? I've been using it in a Revo. After I saw those scuffs, I said, forget it. It's going right in a Revo, and I've been using it in that. I still enjoy your reviews, pal. I see you on Twinkle. This is my Twinkle name. I'm doing a condensed version of this because this is crazy. This is big. By the way, I've seen a closer look at your thing. I see, like, fishing. Ever tried deep sea fishing? No, haven't done deep sea. I did it as a little kid with my dad once. I got sick, and that was the end of that. Come on, Tress. Guy tells me I'm playing pool at my local... Yeah, I love pool. You know, I'm a negative three player. I don't know if you guys know what the rating on that is, but, yeah, I'm a negative three player when it comes to pool. Also, say hello to Amy and the girls. I'm just doing condensed version. There was nothing really iPhone-related here. Also say... Say hello to Amy and the girls for me. Remember what I said. Take no notice to the idiots on YouTube, as they are a minority. The majority of people who watch your videos know what a good guy you are. Peace. Guy's name is Adam. I'm not going to say the names of the people who sent him, you know, like, you know, their screen name or anything. But, yeah, it's signed to Adam. So cool. Adam, you see, I totally read your email. You know what I mean? I'm seeing every one of these. I read a lot of these before on my iPhone. You know what I mean? I read them all as I get them. Actually, just to show you guys, this is no joke. There you go. There's 25 sitting in there that I haven't touched. I have my iPhone set for just show me 25. You know, you can set 25, 50, 75. I have it set for 25. And if I go in my mail and try to hit load, you know, that bottom, you know, where it says you can load up the rest of your mail if you want. There it is. There's 42 more messages sitting down there at the bottom that say load more messages. No, 25 is enough. Let me get through those 25. So these current ones I have not seen on here. Here's another one. Microfiber. Hello, Carlos. Just wanted to ask you what the best microfiber is. Are you going to be doing some type of microfiber giveaway? That's not a bad idea, Andre. There isn't a particular type I like to use. What I look for in microfiber is thickness. You know, is the thickness. The more thicker the fiber, you got to go, Tress. I'm sorry. The thicker the microfiber is to me, the better quality it is, because that's the less you have to push down and the trapping ability of the microfiber, you know what I mean? I don't know if I'm explaining that right, but, you know, the microfibers you get like the 99-cent store, sometimes you go there and they got, it's like real thin. I don't like that at all, because what you're doing is you're actually trapping the dust or dirt or lint, whatever it may be, in that fiber, and you're reusing it again. Whereas if the pile is a little bit thicker, there's, you know, there's more room for the dirt to lie in, or the dust or whatever it may be. I always give it a smack before I actually use it. Once a week, I take all my microfibers and throw them all in the laundry. Light detergent, something light. Don't use something harsh, no powders or anything like that. And spin dry, and then throw them in the dryer. They don't have to be fully dry when they come out of the dryer, guys. No fabric softeners, nothing like that, okay? Just because you'll take that capture ability away from it, okay? So there you go, Andre. That was a quickie for you. Let me get rid of that. Next one. Come on, really? Guy used my line. Come on, really? Guy's name, I see the screen name, but there's no name down here. Carlos, I like your vids, but I'm not going to lie. Your whole give me money, case, wife, candy, biz is pissing me off. This is live. It's pissing me off. You're not a charity case and definitely don't need people to take their money and give it to you. You say it all goes to giveaway. Why, if you're wealthy enough to buy and pay for your iPhone, then should you be able to afford a case for it? This is one of those idiots out there who don't watch all my vids. Go from the beginning, guys. My Incipio gel, the very first case I walked out of the store with on iDay. You know, onto my Flick, onto my Contour Hard Skin, onto the IC, onto the, you know, just look at all my vids. I paid for those. Those are my cases. This pursuit of the case that I'm looking for, that perfect case, I'm buying. What's this dude talking about? Give me, give me, give me. No, I bought all those cases. 20% of the cases there are mine. The other ones, yeah, they're sent. You guys are seeing them every day. You know, I got unboxings like crazy on here. Those are given to me, but it's not give me, give me, give me, send them, no. You know what I mean? Ask these people, regular people, not manufactured, but the people on the internet who've sent them to me. I say their screen names on there. Ask them, send them a PM. Yo, did Carlos ask for that, or was that out the kindness of your heart? Let's see what kind of answer you get. It's stupid. Yeah, look at all my videos. All the cases I started doing these reviews with were mine, and they still are, and I bought them, and half of those I gave away. My in-case slider, I think, might have been the last thing I actually bought. Well, actually, the clarified was. And I'll give those away, too. You know what I mean? Like, nobody's asking for money. I'm not a charity case. We're not wealthy. By no means, we're not wealthy. The wife works hard. I work hard. You know, but really? Wealthy? Wealth in love, wealth in spirit, but really? See, that totally threw me off of this whole video, man. I'm really pissed right now. you can pay for an iPhone, then you should be able to afford a case for it. I'm not saying your giveaways are bad, but don't ask the subscribers to pay for it. Really? You have companies storing product your way for free. Give that away. I am. Why don't you tell your subscribers, don't give that money. Go donate to charity. Give it to somebody who actually needs it. If you actually read this far, please, please plead your case. I would like to hear it. P.S. Don't tell me you're not asking for cases. That's bull. You're hinting extremely hard. Even a 2-year-old could tell you're asking for it. Please do me a favor. Do a mashup of my videos of where I'm asking for cases. It's going to be pretty hard for you to do that because in everything, every time I got an email from before I got that P.O. box, there was like 6 major people that were like, dude, I want to send you something. Please, this would be cool if you did this. And I'm like, nah, that's all right. Don't send it. Keep it for yourself. You know what? I'm done with this one. This is so retarded. Like, gone, delete. Yeah, please plead your case. My channel. Maybe you could check out my channel because I'm starting to do reviews now. So check it out. Comment, rate. Of course I comment, rate. That's the YouTube etiquette. You know what I mean? That's the thing I was talking about. Watch the video. Rate it. I usually don't rate the quality of the video because the camera isn't your fault. What I'm rating is the content. What's in it? Is it informative? Is it not? You know what I mean? and of course I comment in everything I do. And this guy's thing is Live to Skate. LIVE2SK8XD. And he wants me to go in there and check him out. And you know what? I'm not going to delete this one. Right before I finish up this video, I will click over there and I'll check out the video. And you know, we'll see what we got over there. Here's another one. This one's, hey man, this is Eric. Please respond. Hey, can I help you with your site, with your design? I will host your site for you because you have that huge ad banner. That huge ad banner is like crazy. This was like the cheapest thing GoDaddy had just because I was having issues with YouTube and contacting me. And I thought this would be the best way for me to just go ahead and look, oh my God, I asked for help. I asked for this guy to call me and make me an ad. And see, this is still working on my mind, that last bull. You know, it was the cheapest thing I can get away with on GoDaddy where I could just, the cheapest because I'm so wealthy. You know, so I can just go ahead and have a website so that you guys can touch out and reach me, all right? So, Eric, there you go. Maybe I will hit you up. I'll tell you what, let me clear this box. I'm going to delete you definitely right now. Because now I'm going to start to save stuff so I can get back to you later. Let me just delete it. Hit me back later. You'll watch this video. Your name's Eric. You know what you wrote. You know who you are. Which skin? Here we go. You've probably gotten a ton of these questions, but I've been debating the skin to get for my iPod Touch 2nd generation. I don't own an iPod Touch 2nd generation. I own the first iPod Touch. I bought the iClear for that when it first came out. Never thought about it again. You know, that was it. Never. I don't have any cases for that iTouch thing. I don't want a hard, bulky case. Instead, I'm looking for something thin shield, like the Invisible Shield. I've looked at your videos, and you seem to like you do not like the Invisible Shield. No, I actually like the Invisible Shield. So, in your opinion, which is the best? Which should I buy? I don't know which should you buy. It depends on what you want out of it. You know what I mean? Yeah, the Invisible Shields were great. They were awesome. They work great. They're form-fitting. They kept the phone nice and small. That front was a little bit weird, you know, the orange peel effect. I only took that off so I can continue looking for that case I wanted. You know, that with the skin on it, it was real thin and almost like you were going to drop it. And you know what I mean? Even with this skin on it, it feels better than a naked iPhone. You know what I mean? Naked iPhone, it just feels like you might drop it. I actually want a case that feels like I can hold on to it. You know what I mean? Like, so, no, there's nothing wrong with the Invisible Shield. Buy it. Try it. You know what I mean? Just get one for the back. You know what I mean? I think they sell them different packs. Get one for the back. Because with an iTouch, you probably won't be laying it flat down. You know what I mean? You'll be like that. I put my phone flat down because I know you're saying, well, why would you get one for your iPhone flat down? Because sometimes there's texts or something I don't want other people to see. Maybe I'm on a website I don't want people to see. And rather than hit the home button, then go back to Safari and load up that website again, maybe I'll just put it face down so nobody can see what I'm doing. All right, so there you go on that one. No name on there. I'm not going to say your YouTube name again. You guys know who you are. Here we go. Hey, Cardis, I told a friend, and what he said is you should not say, but before I told him, he said, are hiding super capable. Oh, here we go. This is that dude again. Hey, Cardis, I told a friend, and what he said is I should not say, but before I told him, he said, you are hiding super cases. You take it off every video. Literally, that's how it's written. He said, you are hiding a super case. You take it off every video and put some else on so no one can get the best case out there. P.S. Don't think I'm thinking you hide cases from us. You try to show what new. You try to show what new, what good, and what we should get. So, I don't know. I don't think this is that same name. This might be the friend of the person who sent me that first one saying that I hide cases. Hey, I told my friend, and what he said I should not say. But before I told him, he said, you are hiding a... I'm done with this, really. See what I mean? Like, I ain't got time for this, guys. I'm glad I'm actually doing this, because now you can see the frustration that builds up in my mind while I'm reading these. By the way, did you get a chance? This is from Thanks. You know, no name. I got his YouTube name. Again, I keep saying that, but there's no name on the bottom. By the way, did you get a chance to watch the review I did? I didn't upload it to YouTube. I wanted your opinion first. Dude, upload it to YouTube. I think I did see this one. Let me see. There's a link here. Opening media. Still trying to open this media. I think I did see it. It was a video on the iClear, and I was like, dude, how am I watching this by copying and pasting this if... Damn it. Oh, there it is. Okay. I thought I closed out YouTube. If it's not on YouTube, you know what I mean? It was weird to watch it. But yeah, definitely throw it up, man. Who cares? Throw it up. You get the first bad comment, you get it off of there. Me, personally, I like the bad comments in with the good comments. You know what I mean? I like to see who's going to win this battle. Not that it's a battle, but, you know, it's like, you know, there was something where it was like, you are ugly. And it was like, really? You are ugly. That's what somebody wrote. And I left it there. What am I going to negative comment you for or erase, remove that? I don't do that. So it's like, cool, I'm ugly, whatever. And then, like, quickly, somebody was like, dude, you sound disappointed. Are you, you know what I mean? You sound disappointed. You know, you're only here for the reviews anyway. Like, you guys started backing me up. Cool. You know, I like to see that. You know what I mean? That's what keeps me wanting to keep doing these videos for you guys. You know what I mean? Delete. Try this case. Here we go. Will you do a video on it? Now, this is another thing. When I read to you, like, I'll send something else. Like, hey, check out this case. Cool, I will. And then it's like, when you read that one back to me, reply back to that, it's like, cool, when? I don't remember what that other comment before that was. You know what I mean? I don't remember what it was I replied to. I replied to all of them, but I don't know what that video was. So it says, when will you do the video on it? I don't know. Maybe it's a case I have, maybe it's a case I'm getting. I don't know. Delete. Here it is. It's MacBook Trainer. Cool. I knew somebody, like, he was going to be up top somewhere. Just wanted to give you my email address if you wanted to email me directly. This is his name, his address. And there's his video. You know what I mean? Let's help Morpheus out. Dude, I had nothing to do with this. This was totally off the wall. I got my iPhone, saw I had a PayPal thing. What? Somebody deposit money? And then I go in and I find out that this dude's doing this. How great is that? I didn't ask for this. I can't turn it down because, again, my nationality won't let me. It's not what I'm used to. You don't say no. Somebody tries to do something nice for you, you let that person do something nice for you. Always it's been, Cardis, I want to send this out to you. This is great. This is going to, nah, dude, just try to keep it for yourself. Use it. Enjoy it. No, I want you to have this. All right. Look, this is my P.O. box. Send it here. You know, never once, never has it been like, cool, you sent me all this stuff. I'm going to do this to you. That's a lie. Dour Hippo. That Dour Hippo was off the chain. He went ahead and he sent me this K and this, and it was like, dude, you just emptied your whole collection on my lap. You know, I gotta do something for you. And he was the one that was like, dude, look, don't do that. I did it because I wanted to. This is yours. Enjoy it. Do what you want. He didn't even want to take that $10 iTunes card. It was a $10 card. You know, ooh, $10 iTunes card. He gave me like $100 worth of cases. I was like, you know what? No, please give it to somebody else. Do it as a giveaway. I wrote back. I'm like, dude, here's the code. Enjoy it. Because that's just the way I was raised. I'm trying to do something nice for you. Accept it. He finally said, you know what? I'm going to take it. You know what I mean? I will use it towards a program or an app or something. Thank you. But in the future, don't do that. In the future, the dude has sent me screen shields. He sent me cases. He sent me... You guys see the videos. They're there. I haven't sent anything off to that dude. Dour Hippo. What's up to you too, by the way. So there's MacBook Trainer. I'm totally highlighting and copying this and putting this on a file on my desktop right now. All right, you're in. I'm going to delete this. That was MacBook Trainer. Here we go. iPod Touch 2G. I just purchased the iPod Touch 2G. I'm curious to your opinion as to which case I should purchase. I don't know if the quality of the cases for the iTouch, you know, the iTouch are the same as this. I just don't know. I can tell you for the 3G because I've had them, I've held them, I've touched them, I've used them. I don't know for this Touch. And I get a ton of those in there. There aren't too many cases available yet for the Touch. I'm in limbo between the Rebel Touch and the Griffin Wave. I like both cases for the iPhone 3G, not the Touch. I don't want to tell you to get the Rebel for the Touch. And it's just not built the same. Maybe, I don't know. I know that your cup of coffee is the iPhone 3G, but they are quite similar and would appreciate your opinion. Cool. I'll tell you right now. There's no name or nothing, but you know who you are who sent this to me. It was funny. I saw a cup of coffee and I was like, dude, this dude predicted that. Between the Rebel and the Wave, I say Rebel just because of the attention it grabs. Now, here's the other side of that coin. This is a Touch, so you're not going to hold it to the side of your head and demand attention. You know what I mean? That's a hard one, the Wave or the Rebel. I love a Rebel all day long for the iPhone 3G, but just because of that attention it grabs, plus it protects, plus it comes with the whole kit and caboodle. The Wave is a nice case too, though. The Wave is a really nice case. It's just a little awkward to get on at first because you're putting flaps on, but it's a nice case. All right, so I mean, you can't go wrong with either one. Off the top, I just want to keep saying Rebel just because you get that everything else. You know what I mean? So yeah, take that with a grain of salt, dude. You can't go wrong with either one. So whichever one you get, I know you'll be happy with. All right, that's how confident I am in both those cases for the iPhone 3G. All right, so. Here we go. Hey, you're the best. Carlos, I do watch all your vids, but I was just wondering, what camera do you use? Please answer me back. Obviously, this dude sent me something back. All right, so the camera I'm using right now, this one here, is the PowerShot SD870IS. Awesome camera. Awesome camera. Works great. Pictures are amazing. It's a 8-megapixel camera. The reason why I got this is because of the wide-angle lens. As you see, I have it zoomed in right now. From right there on the table, I have it. I actually had to zoom in a little bit, and you could probably still see out here somewhere. I'm 6 foot tall. That's a 6 foot span. I don't know how far up. This arm might hurt. That's why it's not bent all the way. But it's a 6 foot span, my arm. So, you know, go figure. I got it because it was 28 millimeter. The 28 millimeter makes a difference in how much you grab. I figure with this camera, I got it when the girls were born. I figure with this camera, I'm going to be up close to the girls all the time, trying to snap pictures, you know, candids right there in front of them. And I didn't want to be stuck with this much viewing area. So I got the 28 millimeter, which gives me this much shooting ability when I'm up close. Now, when you're far away, it's kind of, you know, a bad thing because now I'm recording all this, you know what I mean, or shooting a picture of all this. So if I shoot at 8 megapixel, I can still totally crop that picture out and wind up with something beautiful. So that's what I'm using right now. It's a PowerShot SD870IS, all right? Delete. Your opinion, contour flick. There it is. I'm telling you, I get that all the time, contour flick. Hi, Carlos, and he gives me his name for Twinkle. Just wondering if you still consider the flick to be a good case. Way back when you did it and you hadn't tried all the others. I only recently got it. I think it's great. I read all the comments about how it scratches a phone, but I put Scotch tape over the rough runners on either side. And it worked out great. Look forward to reading your response. Keep up the good work. All right, yeah, which one is this? The flick. I love the flick. I didn't give the flick away. You know what I mean? That was like my second or third case. I love it. It looks like it's been in a war zone. If you turn it back, it's got scuffs all over, marks all over. I love that damn case. It works great. It's cheap piece of plastic, but it, to me, it was like form-fitting. I never worried about dropping the phone. Bang, 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 bang. So I didn't really care that it would crack or split on me. I pretty much wanted something that was thin, that fit in my folio, that I could just put down. That's all I wanted out of that Flick. And that Flick did exactly that. It's a good case. I still like the Flick. But that's me. Delete. Here we go. Must-haves. Hey, Carlos, I love your vids. I'm going to be getting the iPhone 3G soon. Woo-hoo! And I was wondering what you recommend me buying for it. Do I need something to keep it in, like a pouch or wallet? Something to clean it with? Something to hold it in? Probably a dock. And maybe something else. What do you think I should have? Thanks for your time, Matthew. All right, Matthew, totally, you got to get something to clean the phone with. It's going to drive you nuts. That little piece of fabric that it comes with ain't enough. I always recommend get yourself a case immediately. I didn't leave that store iBay without this. This was the cheapest thing I can find. That was the safest bet for me, you know, to keep it in. And I still rock it today. You definitely want to pick up some iClear. Some kind of cleaning product made for screens. You don't want anything like Windex or anything because the ammonia in that will harm screens. I don't know if it'll hurt the screen on an iPhone because that's glass. So, but anything like LCD screen or plasma or anything like that, it will fade it. You know what I mean? It's like when you take tint. You ever see a vehicle driving in front of you with tint and it looks purple? It's not black anymore. That's because they use Windex on that window. So definitely get yourself something made for that. iClear. Monster Clean. I actually went to Walmart today, and in their section, I bought a can of compressed air. I'm going to do an install later for you guys. I bought, you know, that thing, the spray bottle, the compressed air. But next to it, I saw they had these wipes that were cleaning wipes. And I was like, all right, made for electronics. I was like, cool, that's better than the spray, because now you just pull the wipe down, throw it out, you're done. The other one is they had Panasonic makes a brand of screen cleaner. It's blue, round bottle. It was like $7. I was like, man, let me check out the ingredients. No ammonia, no harsh chemicals, made for screens. And that was only like $8. So check out your Walmart, guys. Get back to me. Do a video response. I love them. Let me know you bought it. And try it out on something. Let me know, because if that's cheaper than the iClear, which I bet it is, it is. I pay $30 for the iClear. The iClear came with that big bottle of iClear, which I used to reload my 2-ounce bottles. Came with a big microfiber, a small microfiber. I still use them in my videos. Came with a little screen cleaner microfiber. Came with 9 packets of iClear in a packet. I've been giving those away because I'm so wealthy. It's still bugging me. I give those away when I give. So usually my little pack that I give away to you people is like, cool, you won this case. In that case, lately, not the first ones because, you know, now I think it's kind of cute that I'm wrapping it up, making like a little care package. It's like your case inside of a microfiber, really nice thick microfiber, by the way. With an iClear, with a screen protector. Like if I know that company didn't include one, I'll include a screen protector and a squeegee and a little thing. Check out ATM. When I sent him his, I sent him a nice little care package and envelope. So, I mean, check it out, guys. That's what I've been doing. Definitely the dock thing, that's holdable. Hold off on the dock. You don't need it. I thought it was cool. One of you viewers sent that to me. And it's great because over at the computer, I just pop it on. But I don't have it connected to my sink. Now I actually have my X stand there. Maybe I should give away that dock to one of you guys. I used it. It's great. Maybe I should include that in a mass giveaway. Whoever gave me that dock, get back at me. And you know what? I'll check the video out and see your name. And maybe I'll contact. Definitely get back to me first, all right? Because I'll go back in the video and check that out. And I'll get your name and see if that's cool with you. Let me pass that on to somebody else. Let them use it for a while. I have the X stand. Boom. Phone goes in. Take the cable. Pop. Let's say I had no X stand. We'll do what I was doing before. Plug it in, put the phone down, you know, with the case. So the dock isn't necessary. Don't worry about a dock, guys. You know, it's nice. If you're going to hook it up to your TV, cool, because there is an out for TV and all that. You get into that later. I'm adding a lot to these simple responses, and that's why I hated typing out. And that's why when I did type out them, things were... It finally got to the point where it was just like quick answers, and I hate doing that because then it seems like I don't care about what I'm telling you. Definitely get yourself a nice microfiber. I usually go to like Pet Boys or something, pick up a nice pack. Go to any 99 cent store if you want. Check it out. If they're like real thin, you know what I mean? Don't buy them. Go to your Pep Boys, and your Pep Boys in the auto detail section, they are nice, thick, puffy. I think AO Bonus just went to Costco or something and bought a pack of 36. You know what I mean? A big pack. Not that you need 36, but, you know, a big pack of 36. And they're like, he said they were pretty thick in the video. They look kind of absorbent, you know. So definitely, let me see, did I cover everything? Pouch or wallet, just get yourself a case. It don't even matter. Here's the one for my day, July 11th. And look, I still use it. Just get yourself any case. Make sure you protect it, okay? That's number one. Worry about what you're looking for later. I'm still trying to find that perfect case, brother, so... something to clean it with. Get yourself the iClear, the Monster Clear, the Monster Clean, or, you know, go to Walmart, see what they got over there, bro. You definitely get something that's made for electronics, something to hold it in, probably a dock. Don't worry about the dock. You'll be all right with that cable, all right? So, delete. Matthew, peace. Unique Skins. Hey, Carlos, you got to check out this website, uniqueskins.com. You upload a picture, you can put it in on a skin on your phone, and it's a customizable jealous skin. Jealous skin? Really check it out. It's ace, man. I just ordered one, tried mine, tried to send a pic of it while on Twinkle, but the server was down. Damn, I want to see what that looks like right now. There is no name on here. Okay, bye. Oh, and tell Amy that was a good unboxing. LOL. So yeah, here we go again. Over to my file. Just take it, drop it down here, right next to that address. I just pasted it. Done. Close. Okay. So here we go. Cool. Let me delete that one. Freebie request. Here we go. Like, you know what I mean? This is from Bunny Drumming. Lizzie, this is the girl that sent all that candy to Amy. I want to respond to something you said in your NATO video. The request came in and you were getting the freebies sent by companies. I think some people who have not, maybe only recently found your site, don't realize the time and effort you put into these videos, and that you do quite often buy the things you are reviewing. So maybe it would be good if you did a video about how you got into these reviews and why you do them. That's not a bad idea. See, I thought I was going to get flamed, and I'm still not done reading, so I may get flamed here. Hold on. Your time and effort is one of the reasons why I sent the sweets. It was to show you the appreciation. I appreciate the video reviews, but also to see Amy do what she promised and give her a treat for putting up with us, all being part of a very extended family. And that's the way I feel, guys. Dude, I thought I was going to get flamed right here. Hold on. The name of that request was freebie request equals and I'm like, oh man. So yeah, that's cool. You guys are like an extended family to me. You know, that's the way I feel. I spend a lot of time with you guys, really. Check out the amount of time in each video and how much time I actually spend. And, you know, and this stuff here I do, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. I'll finish editing this at 1. I'll throw it up. So guys, I do spend a little bit of time on here, guys. Your time is everyone's. I am normally a really laid-back person, but it gets my goat when people post the comments that they can't afford a case or obviously hinting for you to send them something. My theory is if you can afford a phone and package, you can certainly afford a case, however cheap. That's not me saying that, people. That's you guys. I'm only relaying. You know what I mean? I'm begging for cases. Give me a case for free. Please send it to my post box. Oh God, I guess I just hinted again. Stupid. Also, you mentioned a while back about receiving money through ads. I think you should use that money to pay when you post out giveaways. As the cost all mounts up, you should not be losing out at all. You come across as being a genuine laid back, and maybe you do not get wound up. Damn it, I just clicked on it back. Here it is. Come across being a real genuine guy, and maybe you do not get wound up by these things. Why I do, so excuse me for my little rant. Take care, Bunny Drumming. You can see it. I'm not making... Alright guys, this is me, Morpheus, and I'm back. Memory card went full. Totally forgot. I'm still shooting a 640-40, high quality. I'm shooting that on 4 gig card right here. And it totally just died on me. I guess the first half of this video is going to be really good quality. Right now I turned the quality down because now I'm shooting with my older card and it's not as big as this. So I turned down the resolution and stuff so that I can get length out of it, all right? So that last thing there was bunny drumming. And like I was saying, I'm not making this up. This is you guys saying the same things I'm already thinking. So, you know, I double-clicked the next one as soon as I heard the noise over here. So I'm on the next email already, guys. So, you know, this one here is, I can't say the name because there's nothing there. It says, "Hi, Carlos, how are you doing? I watched your wife's unboxing today. For her first, go, she isn't bad. I'm loving your vids, man. Keep them coming. And also, I'm wondering about your old router. If you are doing a giveaway on it, could I please include me?" My giveaways, unless I say otherwise, the only thing you have to do for my giveaways is be a subscriber. That's number one. Just subscribe to my video so you know when I got new content. Somewhere in the video, in that new video, like, I could be doing an unboxing on this, right? And it's like, all right, this is Incipio gel. All right, guys, you know, it's a really good thing. By the way, this video here is a giveaway. Like, I'll put it in the middle of my video. If you're sticking around to watch my videos, sometimes there's a little treat in there, and it'll be a giveaway. And you'll know it's a giveaway, because I'll say, all right, guys, this is a video. Just post a comment, reply, just be active in this video. I'll highlight and copy your name, throw them into a little program, in the hat, boom, bang, this is the one we want you to pick. And there it is, there's a name. I've picked names in Canada, I picked names in the United States, it's picked names in England. It don't care where you're from, all it has is a name. So I'm shipping everywhere and anywhere. And you know what I mean? All you gotta do is just comment in my videos. You know what I mean? Even if you accidentally miss it, say you don't know that this is a giveaway video, you miss it, you walk away to go get something in the kitchen, you come back, and that was the part of the video where I say, all right, guys, this is a video. This is a giveaway video. As long as you put, hey, man, that was a great video. If your name is picked and you're a subscriber, you're getting whatever it was that you were winning. So just be active in my videos. That's all. You know what I mean? Nothing to it. I am going to be doing that router giveaway. Ryan Wade sent me his. It's awesome. It's fast. I mean, you guys see it. It's crazy. And I told him I would totally give mine away to another viewer, and I'm going to do that. So just stick with me here. It's just that I'm doing that other giveaway, the really big giveaway. Maybe I'll do the router before that because I still need another week before I do that mass giveaway. I'm waiting for some other stuff to come in so that I can add to the nice pile. I think right now we're looking at, like, Jivan Hartz, he totally put in a whole bunch of stuff. I think he put in maybe 10, 12 things. I'm looking at wanting to have maybe 20 winners, you know, 25 winners. And, you know, I'm still working it out in my mind, but it's not yet, okay? You probably got another week or two. So, yeah, I'll do the router giveaway soon, like in another day or two. Keep an eye on my videos because that's probably how I'll do it. I'll probably want a video response or something, you know what I mean? If you have a video response to me, maybe I'll highlight your name and put that in the bundle twice versus a regular comment. You know, highlight your name once for the comment, throw it in there. It's not a bad idea. For video responses that you sent me, hey Carlos, I love your vids, keep them coming. That's all. Video response though. I highlight your name, paste it, highlight your name, paste it, so it's in the raffle twice. That sounds pretty good. Anyway, we'll worry about that later. But that router is going to be giveaway, all right, guys? And that's how you get in. Just be a subscriber and be in my vids, all right? Just comment. That's it. I coined that thing. I'm going to say I coined it because I've never heard anybody say it, that YouTube etiquette. Watch, rate, and comment. As long as you're doing that, you're going to win something from me. I'm not guaranteeing you'll win something from me, but that's how you're in my giveaways. That's it. That's all you have to do. My channel, there's another one I kept. Why do I keep this one? Hell, I've been watching your videos and want to know what microfiber you use. Okay, yeah, there you go. Done, this guy's gone. Delete. I've read that one earlier. I was wondering why I was still there. Router, here's another one. Hey, dude, I know you're a busy man. I'm watching your videos. I'm like a fiend. I'm like a fiend, but I'm wondering if you could pass down that router to me if you're not going to do a giveaway. At this time, I do not have a router and can't afford a cheap one. IMK, dude. IMK. I don't know what that means. I'm not up on that. But, dude, it's going on a giveaway. Just be in on that, all right? Delete. No name, by the way. Important. Me and my team want you to write for our blog. Hey, Carlos, it's... is there a name? K. That's his name. I'm looking down at the bottom. K is his name. I have a tech blog, and we have a growing team here writing for it. We cover daily important stories in the tech world. We do... However, need a writer who is big and an expert in a certain topic. We do. Did I just read that about myself? I'm big. We do, however, need a writer who is big and is an expert at a certain topic. We at KIR294, and it's a big name. Would like to invite you to write for us in our blog about cases for pretty much anything. We would really have to. Would you really have to do? You would only really have to do. I would read like a 2-year-old. I'm sorry, guys. Really, man. You only really have to do like weekly posts, if that's the most convenient. But it would be an honor if you joined our team. Please let me know. Keep the badassness coming. That's awesome. I'll tell you what. Let me highlight, copy this. Let me look into that site a little bit and see. Right now, time is such a restraint for me. Time is such a restraint for me just because, you know, the girls, I'm doing this at night. I'm messing around on you know, getting back to you guys. To sit here and actually write a report or something is a little weird. Maybe that's not what you're asking me to do, but, you know, we'll get in contact. We'll talk. Needs iPhone tutorial videos. Are you interested? Here's another one. Hello, I'm the president of... See, and now I don't know if I can read this because... Co-owner. So these people want to use some of my iPhone videos on their website. We're currently building a new website. Is located. If you want to check it out, a majority of it's still under construction, but you can still feel free to look around what is currently on it. We are going to have pages for the iPod Touch, iPhone, iPhone 3G. There are going to be tutorial videos on each page for corresponding devices. We would like to use some of your videos for the iPhone 3G page. We are currently not offering pay for videos at this time. He's already going to do the iPod Touch. If you're interested, please get back to me. I'll tell you what, Christian, I'll tell you what. If you want to use my videos on your page, go for it. All I ask is that you give me credit for it. You know what I mean? Down at the bottom, real tiny, barely visible, you know what I mean? Videos by Carlos Aquino, video by It's Me Morpheus, YouTube, whatever. Just don't act like you make them. Like that one dude, that Soto dude, he was totally passing my videos off his own. That pissed me off. If that same dude had just been like, hey guys, you know, I love these videos, so I copied them to my hard drive and I'm just posting them back up to get more hits for Carlos, great, I don't care. Why would I care if you use my videos? You know, all you're doing is people going, hey, this guy, It's Me Morpheus, sounds pretty interesting. Or, you know, hey, yeah, he's does reviews on phones. Let me check him out. And they're going to further check me out. That's great. I don't care. That's fine. Use them. You know what I mean? Enjoy them. But please give me credit for them. Now, if what you're asking me to do is to shoot personal video for your website, like, hey, guys, this is Carlos at, you know, at Tech Toms, whatever. I can't do that. You know what I mean? Again, I'm just like... You know, the time restraint, I don't feel like I'm giving you 100% of what I can do, what I want to do. Maybe I don't feel your site is giving me 100% of where I want my brand to go. So, again, it's not like, dude, I'm better than you. No, it's not that at all. If you want to use the videos that I've already posted or I will continue to post, great. Just make sure you put somewhere in there Carlos's videos. Hey, I'm YouTube user, you know, It's Me Morpheus, whatever. Just make sure I get some kind of credit for it. That's all. That's it. You know what I mean? Now as a YouTube partner, the videos that I use are now my videos. They don't belong to YouTube. You know how that used to work? Like, okay, make sure you want to upload this video because you do give YouTube rights to do this with it and that. They're now my videos. You know what I mean? So just go ahead, use them. But please, if you're asking me to do personal videos for you guys, I can't. If what you're saying is just a flat out, can we use the videos you already have? Sure, go ahead. Like that battery one. That's a pretty decent one. I looked at that a couple times and I didn't miss anything on that video. I kind of like the way that turned out, so whatever. There we go, Christian. This video is going to be like an hour-long video. Are you kidding me? Who's really going to sit around for this? Maybe you want to go ahead and and favorite this video, and then come back to it, go right to the middle where you left off, I don't know. But I have to put all these together, that one on this card, and the one that's working on that card now. Screen protector advice. Hey, I see that you have tried a lot of iPhone screen protector reviews. I spent so much money trying to find the right protection for the back, for my back, iPhone 3G. I finally ended up with a bodyguard, front shield, invisible shield, rear shield. Sounds like a decent combo. I don't see why you couldn't mix match. That's awesome. When properly installed, the bodyguard is 100% optically clear. It will take a while to dry out, which I learned with my, you know, my invisible shield. And unlike the harder plastic shields, power support, because they are a little bit hard, a little bit firmer, he's got it right on. The bodyguard shield will repair itself from scratches. Yeah, just like the invisible shield. When you touch it with a scratch or something with a key, and you take it off, you see the indentation, but then it'll slowly go away. That's pretty decent. Plus, the texture is much smoother than the invisible shield and Beskins ever. So I haven't tried that yet, but yeah, mine was a little tacky when you ran your finger across. It got some getting used to. It was a little tackier. For the rear, I chose the invisible shield, which is like the Beskins ever. It's not the prettiest, but I like how grippy it makes the back. So some people like the grippiness, some people don't. He's saying that, what is that, that the bodyguards, bodyguards for the front, invisible shield for the back, okay. He's not the prettiest, but he's grippy, so it doesn't slide around in my car. I love that about that. Here's a picture of my full bodyguards install. And he's actually got it up on a website, Mac Rumors. I think you would really love the bodyguard's front shield. Email me back with your thoughts. So he has this up. Let me go check this out. I don't know how I would link you guys to it. And he's over at the Mac Rumors. There we go. Maybe I can give his name on, what is that? Mac Rumors Forms, semicolon Forms, Mac Rumors. His name is Dr. Cabrera, C-A-B-R-E-R-A. Here are a couple pictures I recently took. It's the IS rear shield and the bodyguards. It's much more photogenic. So yeah, he's got a side-by-side. Check it out. That looks awesome. Yeah, check it out, guys. You know, I can't go any further because I'm not a registered user there. So, you know, I am, but I don't think I'm live going in this PC. But all right, guys, yeah, check it out. That was pretty decent. Again, Dr. Cabrera was his name, different name on YouTube, but, you know, Dr. Cabrera is what he was over there. Check him out. His name is there. Dude, your information on YouTube is, you know, on the internet is out, so it's not like I gave your home address, so please don't get mad at that. But, all right, cool. That was a decent idea. He's used the best of both worlds. He used the best of one for the other. That router one. Why is that still there, router? What's up? I'm not sure you're going to be doing with the router giveaway. Let me know. Okay, yeah, I did this one already. Delete. Hey, it's me, Morpheus. Tell Amy that she made a cool and hot vid. And that was Rita Amy. That's it. That's all that was in my PM box. And again, you know what I mean? That wasn't needed inside a PM box. You know what I mean? That could have just stayed in a comment box because I see those. All right. You know what I mean? That's cool, though. Delete. No name, by the way. Hey, have you gotten your hands on the crystal jacket from Power Support for testing yet? On the crystal jacket from Power Support. If you mean the air jacket, yeah, I totally had that. I did a review on that. There's no name on here. I think I did do it, unless the crystal jacket's something new. From Power Support, crystal jacket? Crystal jacket, holy crap, check that out. Whoa, is that a new product for iPhone 3G? Air jacket, crystal film, anti-glare, silicone jacket, and holster, silicone jackets, crystal jacket, and clip. What's the crystal jacket? Color crystal jackets. What the hell's a color crystal jacket? Just because you need protection around it doesn't mean... So this here looks like an air jacket, but with a front on there also. It's not just a back clip. Combination function protecting the crystal jacket for iPhone 3G is totally extraordinary. I'll have to check that out. It comes with one crystal jacket, one film. It kind of looks like it's a front and a back. So it would be the air jacket that goes along on the back, plus some... I'll check that out. No, I haven't. Didn't even know about that. Thank you so much for, you know, for the heads up. There's no name on here, and I don't want to give you a YouTube name. Cool. The crystal jacket from Power Support. I'll have to check that out. See if my Apple Store has that. Hi. Wow. pretty. She's cute. What can you say? My wife would say she's cute. Hey guys. Hi guy. Hopefully you get to read this. I've been trying to send you something, but I keep getting it back. I had a little note saying that since no one claimed it, they send it back. I'm going to try to send it again later on today. Keep up the good work. I enjoy your videos and my baby loves Yo Gabba Gabba too. Her name is, can I say the name? I think I can, right? Akio? She is two. I have two girls, 2 years old the other day. You saw the birthday. I have a name here. Norika? Norco? I'm going to murder this name. Oh my God, you're so pretty. Noriko? Noriko? I don't know. But awesome. You know what it is. It's real easy, guys. My post box is down there. I claim that every day. I go there every morning. It's on my channel page down in the middle of that box. I don't know how much battery I have left. I don't know how much video I have left. So if this dies, I'll kill it. I'll splice them together, send it to YouTube, and I'll make another video if my box gets killed, murdered again. All right, guys? It's Carlos Aquino, first line. Second line, P.O. Box 361. Done. Third line would be Thorofare, New Jersey. Thorofare, space, NJ, space, 08086. That's it. That's all you have to do. Put it on anything to send it to me. I don't know why this keeps getting sent back to you. I check that box all the time. Maybe something on your end. Maybe it's customs sending it back. I don't know if this is even coming from the States. Let me click your name real quick. No, it's United States. It says hometown Tokyo, country United States. So I'm a little confused. But you know what I mean? You've been a member since 2006. So you know who you are. You know what it is you're trying to send. Let's kill that. I'm going to delete it. You'll watch this. I know you will because you're a subscriber of mine. Hopefully you'll see it. Delete. The parcel. My parcel should be in your P.O. box either today or Monday. Not Sunday. We don't get mail. Not Monday, tomorrow, because it's a holiday. Just wanted to add, get Amy to take out the papers first. Read them. Cover up my info. Follow the instructions. Looking forward to your reaction. So, you know, this guy sent something out my thing, I guess because I begged for it. Or because I said, please send me stuff to my box because I need it. You know what I mean? So, yeah, there's going to be something in my box, I guess, Tuesday possibly. So, we'll delete. Gel case. Can the Incipio gel case fit inside the Incase leather folio? Yes, it does, but it's a pain. It does because it's so small, but when you take it out, the rubber sticks to the side because it is a tight fit. You know what I mean? I stretch my folio really good. I started with the phone, then the flick in there. Then I think, what was it? What was next? The Incase slider or the hard skin. That's what it was. The contour hard skin. Put it in there and it just got bigger and bigger and bigger until now. I could totally put a naked iPhone in there. A little bit of play, but once I Velcro it down, nice and tight. Or I can put the Incase slider in there. No problem. It doesn't latch up perfectly, but the Velcro is strong enough to hold. By the way, I hate that Marware sleeve. That Marware, not the sleeve, the Marware pouch, the Marware CEO folio. That center Velcro on that was awful. I put my, now it fit right from the get-go. Like, the slider went right in. No problem. A little snug, but okay. But when I pulled that flipper down, it would pop up by itself. I hated that thing. I used it for the whole day, and I was mad that I took it, and it was just like, forget about it. I wound up throwing this on it at work and just being real careful all day. Okay, so there's your answer to that. It does fit, but it is a little bit tight. You won't enjoy how that feels after the first two or three times you take it off, because this is tacky and rubbery, and it will stick going in and out of the folio. It works, but it's not fun. Hey, Jack Carlos. This is from Denmark. I think you're cool, man. You are so badass. I will send something soon. Some Danish candy to your wife, and something for you, and some photos of Denmark. It's a nice country. Your family should go to Denmark sometime. By the way, the city is Sevenborg, is nice. But if I send you package, you now could. I then put card in package so I could be in giveaway thing, because it's very expensive to send things from Denmark. to US. I'm 14 years old, so I don't have a lot of money, but I will get enough money to send something to you because I have gotten a job. I love your family and you, from Erico, AKA, whose name is William. Cool, William, save it. Hold on to it. Oh no, wait, this is the part where I say, yes, please send me stuff to my box, because I'm telling you, it's still irking me. It's crazy. Hold on your package. Great, you want to send something candy to the wife? Great, she'll love it. She'll do the unboxing, that's awesome. You want to send me stuff? Great. The wife got something in her candy thing the other day. There was a case in there for me. I went crazy, like, wow, there's something in there for me. Great, move over, Amy. So I love receiving things. Here's the thing. Hold off on the package. I understand you're young buck. I understand you just got a job. Cool. Save your money. Wait. Wait it out. Wait it out. In about a week or two, there's going to be that other giveaway, the big giveaway. Hold off to that. Don't send a package now, because I said I was going to do this fair, and I want to get all postcards in fair. I've actually got like 4 postcards that I received yesterday that are my car. They're from like Winnipeg, and some other one that just says giveaway or something. I can't use those. I guess I could have sneakily snuck them in there, but I'm an honest type of dude, so I am not going to include them in the giveaway. I will keep them, though, because I think it's cool. They came from Winnipeg and, you know, somewhere else. I forget where. They're out in the car right now. So just hold off. You don't have to send a package. You don't have to send candy. You don't have to do none of that. All I'm asking for is a 3x5. It ain't got to be a postcard. A 3x5 index card. On the one side, draw a stick figure. Whatever. On the opposite side, put that address I just said, the 361 P.O. Box. You're going to put a stamp on it. I don't know how much stamp it is. It can't be more than $1. More than $2 maybe. And just send it off. It'll wind up here on my table. We'll do a pull. All right, guy, you got first pick. We're going to give you first pick. What do you want? I like that one rebel, or I like that whatever. All right, so just hold off, dude. Don't send nothing immediately. Just please. Oh, wait. No, please send me stuff. I need it because I'm poor, and I need charity, and... which cases, please help. I've had all these. Hi, I'm getting the new iPhone soon. I need a case. I'm looking for black, sleek design, not too much bulk, protection from back scratches. I have decided one of these. Cydio in-case surface combo, the contour flick, the in-case slider. Which would you recommend? I'm mostly tempted for the contour flick, as they have it at my local O2 store, and this funny emblem, 20, I guess that's 20 pounds, 20, whatever, I don't know what that money symbol is, but I'm really not sure. Maybe you could do a video comparing all three. All three are nice cases. You're not going to go wrong with all three. If all you're looking for is scratch protection for the back, you know what I mean, like so you can sit the phone down, I think I touched on that at the beginning of this video. You can't go wrong with the contour flick or the in-case slider. Now that one by Cydio, that's a badass combo. I like that. Arcing Mark just did something on that video, and it was still kind of up in the air, you know what I mean? He had another one to compare it to, but if he didn't have that iFrogs, I don't know what the verdict would have been if he wrote it. Man, I really like the Cydio, but he had something else to compare it to. I like that Cydio. It was a really nice design. It was compact. That holster it came with was really nice. It flicked open really well. There was even a little rubber strip on the bottom of that, so it didn't scratch. It was a good combo. I really liked that. It was form-fitting, tight. Gave me everything I wanted, that protection. I like the Cydio out of the contour flick and the in-case slider. I like that Cydio combo. The Cydio by itself was okay, but I like it with the combo. That holster made it all the better. The contour flick or the in-case slider... The in-case slider, I guess a lot of you people are going to say, I like the flick because it was so minimal. Slip it in, flick it, you're done. You know what I mean? And you can still use it with a folio and all that. So, you know, take it as a grain of salt, whatever you like. I'm telling you, I really like that Cydio as a combo. That was $50 here. I don't know how much that is for you over there. Contour flicker, the slider, you can't go wrong with either one. I personally like the flick a little bit better because it was more compact. As far as you're dropping your phone and protection-wise, I think the in-case slider is going to be better for you than the contour flick. I don't know how long I've been recording, I don't know how much time I have, but I'm going to go right to the end, and when I edit this out, I'll put a little thing on the back, sorry, ran out of battery, or whatever. Delete. Here's another one, microfiber. Hey, Carlos, it's Chase. There you go, he puts his name right there, Chase. I was wondering if you could if you could direct, you know what, next time I do this, I'm just going to write all these questions down, maybe just the answer to all of these and just bang them all out. I'm sorry, guys, this is the first time I ever did this style of video. Direct place quality microfiber cloth because I seriously need one. See what I mean? I answer the same question tons of times in my things. You guys heard the response to this one about the microfibers. If you could send me one, that would be great too. Like, maybe if I could have a used one from your collection, would that be all right? Anyway, I can't wait for your wife, Amy, to do the unboxing video. See, this has been in my box since the 10th. I'm not lying, guys. I try to work from the... I have a lot of stuff. I can't wait for your wife to do the unboxing review. Okay, tell her your viewers are excited. Thank you for reading my PM because I know that you are a busy schedule. I just want you to know that I love your videos, watch your videos, especially the rambling ones, because I always learn or hear something new from you. And I guess I'll talk to you later. Cool. So, you know, he's like, dude, if you got an extra microfiber, PM me, send it to me. Great. I get tons of stuff, tons of PMs about wanting stuff for free. This guy here did it a different way. He gave me some good, it was like a good sandwich. You know what I mean? He gave me some good, banged me out with the please give me something, and then gave me the good part again. You know what I mean? It's, I guess it's a psychological thing. I don't do that. One time, and you guys don't even know about it, and I'm not going to put her information out, but I'm clicking around just on YouTube, you know, doing my own thing, just watching, waiting for a video to upload. I'm on my laptop, you know, doing things, and there was a girl on there, and she was like sick, and she made like two videos, and she made like, that's all she had, was like two or three videos. She was sick, and she has an iPhone. That's how I found her. Click the link, and you know, I don't know if it was like, and I don't want to get the information wrong, so I'm not giving your name. You don't have to say who you are, and I don't even care. But it was like bulimic or something, or it was like, I don't know, you just looked really down in your video, and what you was talking about, having to go to the hospital and being sick and all that, and it was just like, I felt bad. And I got in contact with you, and I was like, girl, you know, what are you doing? And, you know, keep your head up, you know what I mean? Do you own this? Yeah, I do. And how do you keep it clean? Like, we just got to talk, and I was like, dude, I'll send you something out. Here you go. And unfortunately, it took a while to get to her because she was in the hospital when the package came. Her mom took it to her in the hospital. She said it totally made her day. Like, the color was great, and, you know, the microfiber I sent there. And I don't even remember, to be honest with you, what I sent. Like, did I send the screen shield? Did I send this? I don't remember. But I did it because I wanted to. And it made her feel good, it made me feel good, and that's really the only time I think I've ever just given something away to a viewer like that. My things are usually done online, giveaway, got time, it's free, I'm gonna give it away, but I won't go, hey dude, alright, cool, let me get in contact with Chase, hey Chase, don't tell anybody on my channel, but okay, what color do you want? I don't do that, guys. So any ones I really get like that, delete, they go away. Thank you for the nice comments and all, and I hope you still mean them after I, you know, don't reply to you, but if you're asking me for stuff, I don't do that. Sorry to bother you again. No name. I'm not sure if you heard this, but there's one person selling custom capsule combos on eBay. So this here doesn't have a name at the bottom. It was sent to me on October 10th. I know them say YouTube names. Sorry to bother you again. There's no re at the top of this, but it says again. So I guess you told me something before. I'm not sure if you heard this, but there's some person selling custom Rebels combos on eBay. The eBay user is, or something like that, and the YouTuber is, I think, pretty cool. Switch Easy should have offered them that way in the first place. Actually, before I found that vid earlier tonight, my oldest daughter, fourth grader, was watching some It's Me Morpheus with me and looking at the Rebel page on the Switch Easy website. She actually said, oh, you could mix and match the colors out of the mouth of babies. By the way, she wants an iPhone in the worst way, and now she wants the Tiger Rebel. I-M-A-O. I forget what that is. I-M-A-O. No. Not happening. I was looking at the jealous skins, and they look cool, but need a protective case. Do you think they would look good under an Arctic Rebel. I don't know if you I don't think you can see it under the Arctic Rebel. Under the Arctic Rebel with that spine on there, you only see minimal of what you're getting. I would personally say don't get the Arctic Rebel, because with the Arctic Rebel, I got tons of you guys saying something about, by the way, it was eBay name, eBay user. See, I thought I was going to get flamed or something like that, or they wanted me to flame somebody. I don't do that, but Feltboard Fabrics, is that what it is, eBay user? So it says that he's doing that custom combo thing. I think AYO Bonus did something on that, so check that video out. The Arctic Rebel, I'll tell you to stay away from. When I saw the Arctic Rebel on the Switch Easy set, I was like, I don't know about that, because it's going to do... And if you notice, I stick with the solid colors. My first one was a solid color. I kept thinking, you're going to get watermark, you're going to see this. And sure enough, everybody on there was like, dude, you can see it sticking to the phone, you can see watermarks on the back, you can see the injection molding, whatever. I would say stay away from the Arctic Rebel. You're going to get that, and you're going to get this really nice Jealous Skins piece of art, because that's what it was like. Piece of art on there, and then it's going to stick, or you'll see the watermarks, and stick with a solid color, just do the Jealous Skins. The Jealous Skins you saw I rocked for a while. It was beautiful. It stayed on the back. It gave me that protection I liked. It was a little naked, but I kept a hold of it and put it in my folio. When I pulled it out, people loved to see it, because it was beautiful. So, you know, whatever. It will show through, but not as clean or as crisp as you think it will. That Arctic isn't that clear, okay? It's more of a milky, frosty color, so check that out. Hey, just saw your vid. As for the address, send it to the one I PM'd you. All right, so the other day I showed you guys the unboxings and everything that I had, the fishing rod and all that, and I had an in-case slider. That was that one dude the day before that I got in my car chat. You guys know my videos where I was like, this dude was pissed. Like, he sent me a thing and I couldn't get in contact with him. And, you know, I finally get to him and he's flaming me like, dude, you say you get in contact with people and you don't. Da, 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 da. And in the video in the car, I was like, dude, give me your address. I'll go get you your case. Relax. You know, just calm down. Let me just, you know, and I didn't have to do that, but damn. You know what I mean? Guy asked me very nicely, could you get me a case? You know, I'll pay you for it. Guys in Canada, could you pay me for it? Okay, you know, how do I respond to that? First off, I didn't even get the message for a while. And then finally, I get one to the It's Me Morpheus thing. I believe that's where it was, because I got it right to the iPhone. I'm like, this dude is pissed. What is he pissed about? That I won't do him a favor and get him this case, this gunmetal slider, and send it to him? All right, guys, we're back. And, That last one I got it too. So anyway, the guy got mad because I didn't read his email. I'm reading a different thing. I'm not reading. I actually tried to splice this into the. I do need a Mac. All right. So yeah, the way this works is this guy got mad at me because I didn't send it out, or because I didn't get in contact with him, and he thought I was ducking him. Look, ducking him. I went one step further. I told the dude, I said, look, you contacted me this time. You wanted me to send you something. Cool. Throw $35 in my account and I'll go ahead and ship it to you. So I went out, put $35 in my PayPal. I went ahead, went out and bought it. I didn't even charge the dude shipping. I sent it out my own. You know what I mean? So whatever. The thing is out. It should be there tomorrow. Well, not tomorrow. Well, maybe they have mail out there in Canada. But all right. Case. Can I have a wave case? That's literally what this says. Can I have a wave case? Delete. Apple wallpaper. Hey, Morpheus, I love the videos. I went out and bought a slider, and I love the in-depth reviews you have been doing. I love the Apple wallpaper on your iPhone. Can you email me that photo? I really appreciate it. I really appreciate it. But if you're too busy, don't worry about it. I still love the reviews. Thanks a lot, man. That's awesome. And I'll tell you what, I'm not going to email it to you. I'm going to tell you where to go to get it. You just go there and get it. Hold your page, you know what I mean? It's super easy. Let me see. It's here. iPhone wallpaper. There it is. So what you want to do is you want to get on your iPhone and you want to go to this website. It's actually, just go to Google and type this in. SC iPhone. SC iPhone, and the way it comes up on the iPhone is mobile something. So in here it's totally badass, like, cool. There's your different, let me back up once because I accidentally touched art. And the way it shows up is here, all the wallpapers, all right? So there are different categories. Let's go over to anime and comics. There's a really nice one of a tattooed girl. Okay, so then cool. There are all the things, there are all the pictures you see. There's actually a lot of cute girls in there, a lot of superheroes. Cool, we'll click on it and it'll show up right now. Dragon Lady is what it's called. I actually like that. I might actually use that. So cool, there's the Dragon Lady. Okay, see it? All right, so cool. It'll show you what part of her is going to get covered up with the clock. You saw that little option pop up. So we'll click it and we'll close that. We still want it. Right here on the right-hand side, a little bit further to the side, download. Cool, I just click download and a window will open up. There it is. With just that picture in it. So now what I do is I just push and hold, 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 hold. Did it come up yet for me to save that? Isn't that how you do it, guys? Just push it. There it is, yeah. Save an image. Cancel, we'll try that again. Push it, hold, hold, save an image. Save it, where, and it'll save to your wallpapers. Actually, I think it'll save to your camera roll, but later you can move it. Anyway, that's how you do it, guys. That's all you have to do. Hold your finger on an image to save it to your device. iPhone 2.0 required. So there you go. That's where I go. SC iPhone. Check that out, and you can go there, and that's where I got all my wallpapers, actually. Now I don't have to send it to you. You can go there and get them all. Just a quick question. Hey, I love your unboxing. I just made this account about a week ago and have another account with reviews and stuff on it. I just switched up to more of news and updates on this. On this one, can you check out my channel and tell me if you think my videos are good or give me any advice on how I can improve my videos and channel? Thank you so much, Chris. So, Chris wants me to check out his channel, and here it is. Most subscribed this month. Check him out. It's really decent. He's got 129 subscribers, channels, channel views, 956. He's got a couple videos. He's got 22 videos on here. And Apple Update 12, replaceable iPhone, Apple Store field trip, Apple Update, Apple's notebook. I got to check that one out, actually. Is that something on the new... If he had special effects, he would do. All right, so I'll check your channel out a little bit later on. I'll save this. His name is Apple Updater. That's it. Apple Updater, just like that. Guys, check out the page. Give him a little bit of, you know, some criticism over there. Let him know what he's doing good, what he's doing bad, you know, kind of like I like. I like to get stuff like that. I'm actually going to delete you here because I saved you up top here. So, cool. I'll go ahead and delete it, Chris. Probably after this video or during this video, you're going to get a lot of hits or something. You know what I mean? Maybe my guys will go over there and tell you, hey, man, videos look cool, a little foggy on the camera. Maybe your macro ain't set good. Maybe you got, you know what I mean? Get a little close to the camera, get a little far. My guys are decent for that. They're Columbos. They'll help you get better video. All right, so cool. Hey, just want to let you know the item I ordered for you arrived today, so I'll be sending it off to you next week. It's nothing spectacular, but I hope you'll enjoy it. Nothing iPhone related. Alex Manchester. There it is. Nothing spectacular. I hope you enjoy it. Nothing iPhone related. Just want to item I order you arrived today, so I'll be sending it off to you next week. Nothing. I didn't ask for this. I don't know what he's talking about. I don't know if did I say, hey, could you send me this? Could you? I don't know. Actually, I don't know. You saw it. Nothing iPhone related. Well, if I asked for it, I wouldn't know what it is. You know what I mean? Or you know. I was going to say something about being so wealthy or begging for stuff. I don't know what that is. Dude, I didn't ask you for anything. Alex, thank you. I love getting stuff, but I didn't ask for anything. Oh, wait, that was a subliminal message where I say, oh, please ship stuff to me because I said I like to receive stuff. Doesn't everybody? Really, I was just cursed. Thank you. Why is it so hard to find the perfect case? During my long and frustrating search for the perfect case, my iPhone, I call it my iPrecious, LOL. I ran across the mention of you somewhere at an Apple discussion website. I haven't yet had the time to watch all your videos. I plan to, but I've watched several. I love your videos. So I'm a chick. And I'm a bit older than your 18 to 35 target audience. I said that in one of my videos. But I want to rock a cool case too. It's even hard to find cases for chicks. Which is why I got the Agent Flower vest, which I'm still waiting to give away to somebody. I bought that purposely for a chick to give away. There I go again. You know what I mean? Watch my videos, people. You know, I guess that one somebody sent to me, now I'm going to pass it on to somebody. I guess I begged somebody to give me that. I guess I don't have that flower vest right now with the receipt that I paid for tucked in right behind it. Dude, I'm still burned. I'm still flamed over that that second and third email I got. A bit older than you. I love that. Even hard to find cases for chicks, though. See, all your clothes don't necessarily have pockets. Okay, cool. I didn't even think about that for one. All your clothes don't necessarily have pockets that an iPhone would fit in. I don't always carry a purse or bag. I try to wear clothing that does have pockets for the iPhone. But hey, I can't wear cargo pants all the time, LOL. So I need a case that I can throw into my purse or pocket, but also put into some sort of clip or case I can attach it to my waistband. Your video is definitely helping me narrow things down. In so many cases, there's one girl color is pink. Okay, I don't really like pink that much, except the Rebel Cherry. That looks sweet. Sweet, spelled just like that. Anyway, keep it up. I love the videos. And you are very, very thorough. The way you inspect the cases for your audience. I love the way you talk, the way your voice sounds, and you seem to be a classy fellow. Thank you. Well, no, according to some people out there, I'm manipulative. I don't want to ruin your thing. There is no name down here, by the way, so you know who you are. You know who sent that. Right off the bat, I'm thinking of that new pouch that I just received. It's just a pouch. You literally take your phone. It's Mashi. Take your phone, naked or with a case, put it inside the pouch, drawstring it shut, and you're good. Throw that in your pocketbook. Throw that to the side. Throw it in your bag. Throw it in your pocket with the whole pouch. It's kind of a little bulky, I would think, because the pouch bulges up. But if you do what I do, just put a little hook system on the back. Now you can take that hook and click it right to the side of your pants, and it hangs down. I think that might be the best thing for you. Check that out, the Mashi pouch. You know what I mean? See if that works out for you. I don't know what else to tell you. I don't know how many other cases. I know that the Agent 18 comes in a couple of different colors, but I wouldn't throw that just in a bag because then you got stuff hitting the screen. And I don't know. I'll think of something. Just hit me back with a reply to this, and we'll see what we can work out. But yeah, I don't know if there's any other cases out there that, you know, fit the description of what you're looking for. Form-fitting, yet protective, yet girl color. So, all right, you know, that was pretty decent to get that email. That was nice the way you wrote that out. Sweet and over 18 to 35. Little Asian girl, what's up? Hey, Carlos, grats on those SGP. Those look really, really nice. And for the shades video, do you want me to upload to YouTube? How long? Because I only got pictures from my iPhone, no recorder. So you got pictures that you took on your thing. You're going to do something about the shades case. I sent you a shades case, a video. Do you want me to upload to YouTube? And how long? Because I've only got pictures from the iPhone, no recorder. So cool. This is what I did. The pictures I took with that clarify, I took the pictures with the clarify. When you hook up to your computer, it totally comes up as a hard drive. It starts backing up and syncing, but it comes up with, what do you want to do? Open it. You know, find your pictures, highlight them, drag them over to your PC. I opened up Movie Maker. In Movie Maker, import, and you import those pictures in. Take them, drop. Because it's going to be a short video of just pictures, it's not going to be huge. You guys see with my Flip Minnow, literally in 5-10 minutes, I can have a 10-minute video uploaded to YouTube in 10 minutes, uploaded, processed, and you're watching it in about 10-15 minutes. And that's about 600 kilobits. I guess that's a kilobit. 600 kilobits. 700 kilobits, so, you know, I don't think it'll take you long, girl. Just go ahead and upload something and make sure your hair's dead. Alright? Delete. What case? This is a new one all the way at the top while I'm going down. Hey, Carlos, great vids. I hope they're not taking too much out of you. because I love these videos and they are just something about them that I really like. Sorry I'm getting off topic. I'm looking at getting a new case for my iPod Touch. See, I get them all day long. And I wanted to know, out of the spec see-through and the Mashi eye pouch, I know it's not a case, but it still looks sweet. Which one you would recommend? By the way, would the Mashi pouch hold the touch with a thin case? Yes, it totally will. As a see-through, yes, it totally will. I had my iPhone inside of an in-case slider, and it totally fit. I think I actually put my Rebel, not the whole skin, the whole spine, damn it. Not the whole spine, because it's the same size anyway. But just to see, I put it in there, totally fit. So you can actually do both. I think that, what was it? The see-through is actually pretty decent for the iTouch. Just because it is form-fitting, it does. That, the iClear, just something that's form-fitting, it's nice and strong and supportive, you know. And again, it's an iPod Touch. You're going to take it, put it in your pocket anyway. You don't have to risk dropping it, you know what I mean, on the street. And if you do, it's not going to happen as most... It's not going to happen as often as somebody with a 3G. Somebody with a 3G is totally going to drop their phone more often than somebody with an iTouch just because their phone is to their ear all the time or it's ringing and they're popping it out. When you listen to your iTouch, it's probably in your pocket and you're listening to your music and that's where it stays. You don't have to worry about the phone ringing, popping it out quickly so you can answer it. You know what I mean? So just get a case in there. But yes, it will totally fit the Mashi iPouch and that case totally works. I used it. I loved it. Delete. iPhone shields. I would like to ask if what shield do you prefer, the Zag Invisible Shield or the Power Support, or any suggestion you can give me. I'm really having a hard time deciding. All right, so Power Support, I love their shields. I really do. They're just a film. They go over the screen, and they protect your phone. I like the clear. I love the way that feels, the clear. The anti-glare is a little bit frostier of a look, but it's minimal. You still get fingerprints, but it's minimal. And it feels a little weird. It feels like sandpaper, like real thin grit, and I didn't like that at all. So I prefer the glare. You still get the glare with the anti-glare. It's just diffused. It's not as blinding. But really, if I got a little bit of glare there, cool. I tip it a little bit more. Oh my God, I got glare there. Cool, glare's gone. You know what I mean? So that's why I like the crystal. The Invisible Shield's a totally different animal. That Zag Invisible Shield, that is like, you can literally take a key and scratch it. You will get that orange peel effect. I don't care how long you let it dry. I did it twice, and I still had that orange peel. It got better on that other install I did, but it was still there. It's a little bit tackier. You may not like that. You know, when you touch it, it does feel a little weird. But it is protection. With the Power Support screen shield, it's protected, and you can drop, you know, a memory card, or something can hit it, and you're okay. Like the other day, I pulled my phone out, grabbed the keys out of the ignition, and the key hit the... And it totally protected. There's nothing there. But if this hit gravel or something, then yeah, you probably could chip or scratch Power Support really bad, whereas the Zag will just laugh at it. So there's my 2 cents on those two products. Do what you like with it. I like the Power Support, but some people need the protection of the Zag. So there you go. There was no name, by the way. 200th video. I didn't even realize it was a 200th video. I just pop videos on here like they're Tic Tacs. You know what I mean? Like I'm popping Tic Tacs. Your next video is going to be 200th video. Nice job. So this shows how long ago this email was, guys. I'm not kidding. I got video messages here forever. It's 11:39. I've been here since 10 o'clock. I guess I got an hour and a half video. I don't even know. I'm sorry, guys. Again, take this video, pause it, leave. Kill it. Just remember where you're at in minutes, and then just come back, click right to there, and do it. I'm like me. Check this out real quick. Let me go to my YouTube. I'm going to open up another window. Go to YouTube. Here you go, John for Lakers talking about the berry, the blackberry storm, right? So, cool. It's an 11-minute video. Say I already saw the first 10 minutes video. I'll click in the center.
Hey, guys, John.
That was the beginning.
Just blackberry right now.
Now I'm at 6 minutes, 24 seconds.
Your applications, maps, just have built-in GPS.
So you can, see, I'm for real. So you can click in the middle of the video and go right to a certain part. Let's say I want to go back to 6:24.
Four-shot list.
Alright, so yeah, you can totally do that, guys. Alright, so if you need to delete or close my video, close it out, just come back and finish watching it, because there's a lot of things I'm trying to hit on here. Here you go, high quality video. Hi, Carlos, I noticed that you can always watch your videos in high quality. How can you upload these? I upload my video, and when I try it, there's no option for switching to high quality. Alright, so when I upload a video like this one, my high quality vids, I'll shoot up to YouTube. Sometimes I minimize how big they are so that I can get more information on the card, but when I upload to YouTube, the first hour that they're on YouTube, they can be the highest quality selling, and they don't show on there, and they look a little cheesy, because I guess they're still processing in the background on YouTube's end. They'll be visible to you, but they won't look as good. Come back in 2 or 3 hours, or come back the next day and watch that video. It's amazing. It's crystal clear. It looks good. And if you haven't done that whole, because if you go to my account, more, down at the bottom right under account, it says video playback quality. It's the second one from the bottom. If you click that, here it is. Choose the default video settings. Choose my video quadrically, dramatically based on my current connection speed. The second one. I have a slow connection speed, never play my video in high quality. Third one, which is what I have. I have a fast connection, always play in high quality. So it'll always just go to high quality. It don't even ask me anymore, okay? Some videos I upload there and they're not in high quality. Some videos, they are in high quality. There's nothing you can do to make it high quality. Just shoot in high quality. I guess they know it by the file size or something. I don't know. My videos I shoot at 640 by 480, 30 frames a second. That's what I shoot at, and I send them. And they come up high quality. I don't know. All right, delete. A whole cup of coffee. It's 11:41 at night. A contour flick. Oh, God, he dropped it. Hey, Carlos, I just want to let you know I dropped my iPhone today. Sad face. This is from Stars, by the way. I was going to put it in my pocket, but missed, and it fell on the concrete about a good 2-3 feet. Since you've asked a few times about how the flick would hold up, I thought I'd message you. It held up really well, actually. There's just a few scuff marks on the back now, but I didn't crack or anything. You don't have to respond to this message. I know your PM is filling up. I just wanted to give you an answer to your flick question. Great vids. Keep up the work. I'm still going to post a vid response as soon as my brother gives me back my camera. He borrowed it for a trip. That's awesome. So now we know. If you're putting a phone in your pocket, the flick, the iPhone with the flick on it, and it goes in your pocket, you miss, about 2 or 3 feet drop, you're good. It's not going to crack. It's not going to split. It's not going to open up, and your phone's going to slide out. It works. Worked for this guy. Stars, thank you so much, man. That's awesome. You know, it's a little informative for somebody else. Incipio Silicrylic Gel. Hey, Carl's been watching videos. Awesome. I just wanted to ask you about the Incipio gel. I noticed that you don't ever show that case in your videos anymore. I have that. It's the one with the two skins, black and white, and then there's a plastic piece. It looks like an X. It's got a square in the middle for rubber. Kind of like a Rebel, kind of. Anymore? Did you give that away, or do you just not like it? My question is, I just got the Marware sleeve, and I love it. I use my Capsule Neo with it. Marware sleeve. Okay, cool. Yeah, the sleeve. I like that. That was pretty decent. I use it with my Capsule Neo with it. It works great. I was just wondering, though, would the Incipio Silicrylic combo fit smoothly into... And that's the thing. As soon as you put a case with even a little bit of rubber, I didn't pull that out because that's like sideways in my case. I keep some stacked up like this, and the other ones are like this in my Tupperwares. Any case that had any little bit of rubber was a pain, because, you know, to slide in and to pull out of that sleeve. Yeah, it'll work. It'll totally work. And I know you're saying, yeah, but most of that back was an X-brace, which was plastic. Yeah, but you still had rubber on the front, and you had a square block on the back that was rubber. And it's just, I guarantee, I'm telling you, before I even go test it myself, when you put it in and out, it's going to get a little tight. I don't recommend you use that. That's just me. The sleeve, awesome. The Marware sleeve was pretty decent. And the Neo was okay when it was on, but you know, I just didn't like putting it on, taking it off. That was ridiculous. I had it for a couple days. Day 4, day 5, shipped it off to Australia. Music Nation, what's up, man, by the way? Fit on Marware sleeve, I suppose. There you go, just got another email. Sent you, hey, thanks. So I'm getting messages in the background, which if I refresh this page, it'll probably show. Sleeve just saw in the video smoothly anyway. You keep the advice, thank you. iPhone GG holsters, keep them coming. Alright, so yeah, I'll totally do something on the holsters once I get more. Here you go. As soon as I delete that, bang, that email I just got just showed up at the top. So hey. Hey man, just been watching your videos.